Hi, and in this Growth Engine Daily, I want to talk about the sensitive subject that I often get asked, which is, should I put pricing visible on my website? It's a great debate. It's one that, you know, is divides the room, if that makes sense. But before we go any further, I do want to give credit to Marcus Sheridan at the Sales Lion for this strategy. I would highly recommend also you go and pick Marcus's book up, which is They Ask, You Answer. You can get that on Amazon and things like that, and this covers this particular strategy, or one of these strategies. So it's one that we use in our inbound agency, with clients, and my recommendation is, yes, you do put your pricing on the website. So first and foremost, I just want to address some of the fears that you may be having, because if you sat there thinking, Mike, you'd be bold about that statement, why should I put pricing on my website? Well, first and foremost, number one, what it allows people to do when they visit your site is they're going to have a look around, and if there's an element of interest, guaranteed the first thing that they're not going to do is go straight to your pricing page. You know, if they've come for software, or they've come from engineering, or they've come for consultancy, they're probably going to read some content, whether that's on the homepage, your services page, maybe they've been brought to your page because of some type of offer or email, or maybe they're on an existing list. So the first thing they're going to do is have a look around. And if they're going to have a look around and then there's an element of interest, if they do see the pricing, yeah, they may check that out. But why is that a major problem? It isn't. And it isn't because if, for example, your price point is, say, midpoint, and the people who are visiting your site are super low, what it's going to do, it may reduce the inquiries that actually come into your business. But ultimately, if you're being honest and you speak to your sales managers, how many of the leads are fully sales qualified, whether the perfect fit customer for the perfect fit product at the perfect fit price point? The chances are you're going to be in 10, 20, 30, maybe 40%, you know, if you're pushing that way. So what we found, we adopted this strategy after reading Marcus's book in October of last year, which is 2018. And whilst we saw, a reduction, 5, 10, 15% reduction in inquiries, what we found is the people that were actually making the inquiries were of a better quality. They've seen what content that we produce, they see what services we provide at the agency for HubSpot, they have a look at the pricing tariff, and then they make an inquiry. So what that tells me is they're already aware of the pricing. Yeah, they may negotiate, they may want to put a custom sort of deal together, but ultimately, they're making that inquiry fully aware, and it sets the standard. Having a good pricing page is key as well. It's not just about saying my service is X. You need to treat that, your pricing page, very much like a sales page. I'm not talking a long form sales copy here, you know, where you see these pages from some of the American gurus, if you want to call them that, that the sales page is like a roll of wallpaper. Not saying that. You know, what I am saying is give some context, give some value, structure it in a way that is obviously, you know, welcome to the investment page. Give a statement about, you know, your pricing position and the value proposition that you give. Remind them of that. Move them into the packages, whether it's ABC, gold, silver, bronze. You know, here at the Success Hub, we have plus, pro, and premium. We've got a starter and then like a premium plus, which is slightly out of scope. But ultimately, the core products are plus, pro, premium. And then we break that down and we give them interactive options so they can slide to say, if I want to move up, what do I get included for that price? If I move down, what do I get, you know, either less or more? So make it an interactive page. Give them something to get involved with. Give them something to participate in. We know the importance of interactive content, and we know the importance of how that moves people better than static images. And it's competing and sometimes out-competing video. If you want to put a video on there about your pricing, again, that's absolutely fine. So the viewpoint I've got is, should you put pricing on your website? Absolutely. It pre-qualifies people. It allows you to be transparent. It allows you to engage the people, especially if you're going interactive. And, you know, are there any businesses out there, I get asked, the way you wouldn't put it on there? And to be honest, no. I think if you haven't got your personas sorted out, you haven't got your search engine optimization sorted out, and you're just bringing anybody to your website, and then you're burning your salespeople's time, or especially if you're consultative selling, that could be a big drain on your time, which is valuable. So what I would say is, regardless of business, get your packages and products sorted out, get them as baseline products, put a pricing page on there, make it interactive, and start to filter and qualify. What I would always do as well, I recommend to put something like Hotjar on there, so you can see that at hotjar.com or hotjar.co.uk, and that's going to give you like scroll maps and click maps, so you see what people are doing on your pricing page. Are they looking at it, not scrolling, then clicking straight off? Which maybe give you an good indication that the price is not offended, but it may be that they're not at that level. That's something that you might be able to do. And also a great situation there is to put a pricing guide on there. You know, people will look at it, but if you engage the people, put a PDF download on there where you can either give it on a thank you page or drop it in an email afterwards, where people can take that away, read it in more context, and it acts not a full website offline, but you can take your key points off your website and then ultimately drop that into a pricing guide, build context, and they're ideal for influencers and decision makers to use in boardrooms and management meetings to get decisions. So I hope that gives you my view on it. Again, big credit to Marcus Sheridan at The Sales Lion. It's his strategy, not mine. I'm just sort of giving my sort of review and viewpoint on it. And as always, thanks for continuing your growth engine journey. We really appreciate it. Go do the hustle, go make it happen, and we'll catch up with you in another Growth Engine Daily real soon.